variational equations. In this lecture, we state the variational problems in the equivalent form of the variational equations. Namely, let L be a positive definite operator in the Hilbert space H. Multiplying the linear abstract equation, this equation, by eta in the Hilbert space, new Hilbert space generated by the positive definite operator L, we obtain the following variational form of this equation. This is variational form of that abstract equation. The variational equation holds for all eta in the new Hilbert space HL. The following theorem holds. Theorem. Let L be a positive definite operator in the Hilbert space H. Then there exists unique solution U0 in the Hilbert space HL generated by the positive operator, positive definite operator capital L of the variational equation. There is unique solution of this very variational equation. Proof. By the theorem proved in the previous lectures, there exists a unique element U0 in the Hilbert space HL at which the functional, this very functional, attains its minimum in the Hilbert space HL for the given function f in the original space capital H. Therefore, the inequality holds. So, the value of the functional at U0 is less or equal but than any value of the functional with the argument shifted by U0 shifted by t eta for all eta and t from minus to plus infinity. So this fact we have established on the base of the theorem from the previous lecture under the assumption that L is positive definite operator. So from that theorem we got the unique element in the Hilbert space U0 at which this very functional attains minimum. Good. We note that this value f of U0 plus t eta is the quadratic function of the variable t. Indeed, by the definition, the value of the functional at this very argument is L times U plus T eta times U0 plus T eta, according to that formula, minus 2F F U0 plus T eta. So we have, here should be comma, this is quadratic equation because of the variable t, because the coefficient at t square, we shall have L t eta and here t eta. So we have t square and L eta eta, which is here. The coefficient at t will be L t eta times u0 and also L u0 times t eta, this t eta. Because the operator is positive definite, that is symmetric, therefore we have two values L u0 eta minus L minus minus f eta and the common factor 2 we take a front of the square brace times t. We remain with L0, LU0 minus 2, LU0, LU0, minus 2 fu0, which is f at u0, as we have the definition of this very function. So, taking on other side this value, we observe that the difference f at the argument u0 plus t eta minus f at u0 is this square brace. And this is the quadratic function of the variable t with the coefficient at t square non-negative, and the free term independent of t in this quadratic function is zero. So this quadratic function is always non-negative, greater or equal to zero, then for all real variables, is the discriminant. The discriminant will be this value in the square brace. We can write it as this one, square. So that is square. This is the discriminant of this quadratic equation, observing that the term independent of t is zero. So the square of this expression is less or equal than zero. This is this fact comes from that the quadratic function is always positive if the discriminant is less or equal than zero. But the non-positive expression is greater than zero and less or equal than zero. That means that it must be zero. So for all eta, we have that. So this equation we can write in the form of the equation L u0 minus f times eta equals to zero. So the u0 satisfies the equation L u0 f, and therefore u0 is the weak solution of the abstract equation. End of the proof. Also, the following theorem holds. The theorem: let L be a positive definite operator in the Hilbert space again. So if u0 in the new Hilbert space HL is the solution of the variational equation for all eta in HL space, then the functional, this very functional, attains its minimum at u0. That fact we can also prove by the assumption we assume that u0 is the solution of the abstract equation. Then we have the difference f eta minus f at u0 equals this expression is f at point eta, this expression is f at point u0. This is equal. Now we can substitute instead of f LU0, this u0, for this f LU0, for this f here LU0, because u0 is the solution of the equation. Okay, now we can take common factor L eta, at eta is the factor, so we can have L eta minus LU0, but one LU0. We have minus 2, then 1 LU0. So we have L eta minus u0 times eta. The other L0 eta is here. From here we can add. From here we remain with LU0 u0. It will be reduced. So from here we can find again that this, we can take common factor LU0, and then we have eta minus U0, with minus. Because the operator is symmetric, then we can move on L on this argument eta minus U0, so we write here. and that term remains as it is. So again, we have common factor L times the difference eta minus U0, and we remain with eta minus U0. And this is a positive definite operator, so the product of the element L eta minus U0 times eta minus U0 is non-negative, greater or equal than zero, for all eta. So the difference is greater than equal than zero. So from that we find that f of u0 is less or equal than the value f at eta for all eta in the new Hilbert space HL. It means that the operator, the functional, attains minimum at u0 in the Hilbert space HL. This fact we write that f of u0 is minimum over all values f at v for v in the energetic space HL. Example. Let us recall the equation we have in the previous lectures, that second derivative equals the function which is discontinuous, this very function. So with the homogeneous boundary value conditions at 0, 0, at 1, also 0. So the variational form of this equation is that if we multiply this equation by eta and integrate from 0 to 1, we remain with that fact. If we integrate by parts, then we come this formula on the band on the, at the ends of the interval u is 0. We have here 0. So if we integrate again by parts, then we shall move. We can move the derivative from eta. Here should be derivative eta. Here should be derivative eta. So there will be eta times second derivative of this with minus, which is minus 4. We have here. Or this equation, we write this equals this for all eta. Good. So that equation, variational equation, holds for all eta, and the new Hilbert space is the Sobolev space W012. By the theorem we have proved before, this equation has a unique solution U0 given by the formula. That is minus half x in the first part from 0 to half, and 2x squared minus 5 over 2x plus half in the second part from half to 1. Indeed, this is the solution. We can check. This is the solution of the variational equation. It's not differentiable at point half, of course. It's continuous but not differentiable, so it cannot be a regular solution. But it is weak solution of the equation, and this is the solution of variational equation. Indeed, if we take left side of the variational equation and we come to the differential by parts, we come here, because the u0 with respect to x, we can write minus half eta. The integral exists, of course, because this function, if we remove one point from the interval of integration, the integral remains the same. Plus, from this is from the from 0 to half, this is from 0 to half, and this is from half to 1. And that is this equation. So for all eta in the domain. Thank you.